Good morning to everybody. Today, my lecture is based on food shortages of India. The increasing population of the country has threatened mankind in several ways, amongst which the most important one is the food problem. Fish being a valuable and easily accessible source of food can be used to overcome the food problem of the country to a certain extent. The flesh of fishes is delicious, palatable, and highly nutritive, containing proteins, fats, particularly omega-3 fatty acids, minerals, and vitamins, particularly A, C, D and E. About 12.8% of total animal protein consumed in India comes from freshwater fish. India is the third largest country and the second largest aquaculture fish produced in the world. Except for some sharks caught for food, majority of fishes of India are teleosts. Most popular freshwater food fishes of India fall in the superorder Teleostei of subclass Teleostomi. The carps, either major or minor, and catfishes of the order Siphoniformes constitute about 64% of freshwater fishes of India and are very important food fishes. The carps and their allies form the division Cyprini, comprising of about 200 genera. The catfishes fall into a second natural division, the Siluri, which also embraces about 100 or more genera. Despite significant consumption of fish by Indian people, that is 12.8% of the total animal protein sources, the country still falls short on fish protein. Availability at 5.04 kg per person per year compared to world consumption at 20.5 kg per person in 2009. Here, I will describe the most important freshwater fish food fishes of India, particularly Labiorhoeta, Katla Katla, Sirhynes Pregalla, Vallego Attu, Channa species, Notopterus species, etc. I will explain one by one. The first freshwater food fish is Labiorhoeta. Labiorhoeta is the most famous major carp found all over northern and central India up to the Godavari River. This is one of the finest of food fishes, grows to 80 centimeters or more. Body of the fish is elongated with moderately rounded abdomen. Head is prominent with blunt snout. Lips are thick and fringed with a distinct inner fold above and below. And there is one pair of short and thin barbels and robust body narrow suddenly towards tail. Color brownish gray to blackish above. Scales with orange to reddish. Caudal fin is deeply forked. This person is deeply forked. Rohu reaches sexual maturity between 2 and 5 years. It depends upon the availability of the food and conditions of the habitats. Breeds in flooded river during monsoon period. Female lay eggs about 2 million eggs at a time. Spawns may be collected from rivers and reared in tank and lakes. This fish never breed in the ponds. It requires the induced breeding, artificial breeding devices. This fish may attain a length up to 45 cm and a weight of about 675 gram in 1 year. And the younger fry feed on zooplanktons and flares, but adult fish is vegetarian. Fry may be transported over long distance with little mortality. Besides Labio rohita, some other species of the Labio is also used in the as a food fish, that is Labio calvasso, Labio dero, Labio baga, Labio bonius, and Labio bat. The other important food fish is Katla. Katla is one of the fastest growing and largest Indian major carp, attaining a maximum length of a meter. It is found throughout India, although rather scarce south of the China Krishna River. Katla lacks an upper lip, while the lower lip is doubled outwards. Eyes of Katla are large and situated in the anterior half of the head. Dorsal fin is inserted above tip of the pectoral fin. Color is blackish gray above and silvery on the sides. Scales with pink or coppery centers on the dorsal side and whitish below. Katla migrates towards river in the plain regions in breeding season, that is from June to August. After 16 to 18 hours of the fertilization, larvae are hatched, which measures about 4 to 5.5 millimeter in length. The young ones measure up to 15 to 20 centimeter in length and feed exclusively on water flares. It may grow 7.5 to 10 centimeter per month and 1 kg per year in weight. Katla is a very strong fish and may jump over the fishing net captured inside the net. Sirhinus mrigala, that is the next food fish of the India, also called mrigal in local area. It is popular as a food fish and an important aquaculture freshwater species throughout South Asia. This fish is a very important component of the polyculture system of three Indian major carps along with Labio rohita and Katla. Katla. This carp resembles with Rohu, Labio rohita, in general shape but is somewhat more slender. It has wider mouth and thinner lips. Body is silvery dark grey along the back and sometimes with coppery tinge. Upper margin of the body is concave, particularly in the posterior side. The dorsal fin has 15 to 16 rays and lateral line scales are 40 to 45 in number. Pectoral, pelvic and anal fins are orange in color, tipped with black. A pair of small barbels are also present. In natural condition, breeding takes place in flooded river in monsoon like Labio Rohita, that is monsoon period is July to September, but fails to breed naturally in pond, thus induced breeding is required. Growth is recorded 25 cm in a year. Fingerlings and adults both feed on the huge amount of decaying organisms. Major food consists of sand, mud, algae and decaying vegetations. Males attain maturity after 1 year, while the female mature before completion of 1 year of the age. It means the female mature prior to the male. Adult attains a maximum length of 90 to 100 centimeter and a weight of 1.4 to 2.8 kg. Besides Serranus mrigala, there is other species also, that is Serranus riva and Serranus chaudhrai, that is Srivastava, used as a food fish. The next important food fish is tortoise or barbus tortoise, that is also called mahaseer. That is this fish is found in the hill streams and the upper reaches of the rivers in the northern latitudes. Mahaseer grow to a large size, about 1.2 meter long, and ranks very high as food fish. Fish is oblong, somewhat compressed, with the head broadly pointed in front. There are two pairs of barbels, which are more or less of equal length. Body is covered with large cycloid scales. In fact, the mahaseer's scale is rated as the largest among the modern teleost. Very large scales. The dorsal fin is inserted above pelvic fins. Anal fin does not reach the base of the caudal fin. The caudal fin is deeply forked. The ventral profile is more arched. Body color is silvery. Or grayish on the back and on top of head. Fins are yellow with a red margin. It is also considered a good game fish by anglers. They are now cultured in dams in Punjab, like the Bhakra Nangal. Their body is adapted to counteract torrents and fast moving streams. The snout is pointed, the body narrow, and the tail is long, like salmon. They can help against currents and ascent waters. The next important fish is Valgo Attu. It is most widely distributed celluloids and found in river and lakes throughout India. Due to its large mouth, teeth, jaws and predatory habits, it is often referred to the freshwater shark. Head is very large, trunk is small and tail disproportionately long and tapering, has two pairs of barbels, one long pair in the maxillary and one short in the mandibular, one on either. The anal fin is very long and end near the caudal. The caudal fin consists of two rounded lobes. The upper lobes is longer. The body is laterally compressed with a straight back. The color of the fish is uniform gray, somewhat darker above and lighter beneath. The fins are sometimes covered with fin dots. It has a long snout with a slightly projecting lower jaw. The cleft of the mouth is very deep. Lateral line is complete and simple. It is not popular for stocking in tanks because it attacks on other fishes, particularly young ones of the corpse. The specimens usually coming in the local market are 40 to 70 centimeters in length. It grows to a size of about 1.80 meter. That is a large fish. The next important fish is the Clarius buttricus. This fish found in the freshwater as well as in brackish waters also throughout India. It is supposed to be a poor man's fish and is found at dirty muddy bottom of fresh and brackish water. It grows about 45 to 50 centimeter in length. Body elongated, color uniform brown or grayish by black, head depressed with top and sides, covered with osseous plates, caudal fin rounded, pectoral fin reaches below the commencement of the dorsal fin, barbels four pair, pectoral fins with spines, hence may be regarded as a poisonous fish, dorsal without spine, no adipose fin is present. The external serration of the spine is prominent. Lateral line is complete. Gill chamber of this fish are tree-like organs, especially designed to take in oxygen from the air, and hence it is included in as live fish. Its breeding season is from April to June, and it is a delicious fish and fishes more prized than the Indian major carps. The next important fish is Notopterus, and the two important species are found in India, that is Notopterus chitala and Notopterus used as a food fish. It is commonly important as a food fish, also called featherback, having convex dorsal profile. The abdominal profile is straight. It is actively a North Indian razor fish, named razor because of its long, straight and fin. So this is called razor fish. The body is coppery brown or grayish along the back with 15 or 16 silvery transverse bars. Average length 25 cm but may reach a meter. Body is laterally compressed and the back is strongly humped in front. The ventral fin is long and almost continuous with the caudal fin. Dorsal fin is small. Its snout is obtuse and convex. There are two distinct spines, one on either side of the throat. It is carnivorous fish. The flesh is very much tasty. It is mainly found in the rivers Ganga, Brahmaputra and Mahanadi. Another species, Notopterus, that is also called Pallas, which is also in demand as food fish. It is commonly called the Patra in UP and Bihar, Folni in Bengal. Average market size is 25 to 45 centimeter, but maximum size may be about 60 centimeter. It is cultivated in large lakes and reservoirs of Tamil Nadu. Both the species of Notopterus are almost total air breathers. Their gills are small and reduced, and it If these are denied access to atmospheric air, these are asphyxiated. These have an open air bladder, which is similar to the vertebrate lung. The next important fish is Channa ophiocephalus punctatus. The other varieties are also available in Indian water. That is Ophiocephalus striatus, Ophiocephalus maruleus, Ophiocephalus gachua. Channa punctatus, Channa striatus, Channa maruleus, and Channa gachua. Their body is dark brown or greenish brown above and yellowish below. The color varies according to the surrounding water. In brackish water, they may exhibit purple color. It may attain a length of 30 cm in plains, but on hills it is only about 12 cm. It feeds on worms, insects, small fishes, tadpoles and frogs. Hence it is carnivorous. There are prolific breeders, and the development is much rapid. These are widely cultivated in tanks of Tamil Nadu. Abdomen is rounded and the head is rightly depressed. Teeth are present on jaws are equal. Dorsal and anal fin are elongated but spineless. Caudal fin is separate and round in shape. Eyes are lateral and moderate in size. Pelvic fin has more than half length of pectoral fin. Scales are of cycloid type. Accessory respiratory organs present in the form of folded linings in the paired cavities on the roof of the pharynx. Murrells, this fish is also called murrells, having soft flesh divide of the fat, are considered to have medicinal value and provide nutritious food, particularly to the sick people. And the important fish is Angulia bengalensis. This fish is also called freshwater eel, have a snake-like body, famous for their periodic migration and interesting life history. Angulia bengalensis has been reported as a freshwater eel for food and is included in family Angulidae, but rest species are marine. Freshwater eel attains enormous size of about 120 cm, but is a poor man's food fish. The color is brownish along the back, becoming yellowish on the sides and beneath. The whole of the upper surface of the body is covered with black spots and blotches. The head is broader than the body. Tail is long. Scales are absent. Dorsal fin long and ventral fin absent. Pectoral fins are also missing. It is found in the gangetic estuaries, the way of Bengal and Indo-Pacific region to the seas of China and beyond. The next important fish is Harpodon nehrius. This fish is also called Bombay duck. Inhabits in deep water, offshore, on sandy mud bottom for most of the year, but also gathers in large shoal in deltas of rivers to feed during monsoon. That is aggressive predator, spawns 6 patches of broods per year. This fish has a semi-transparent appearance. with compressed and elongated body, extended lower jaw. The most prominent key character is the extension of the lateral line up to the pointed median lobe of the caudal fin. Primarily caught along Maharashtra with the bag net, better known as doll net. This fish is very phosphorescent, excellent food fish, marketed fresh and dried or salted, consumed, pan fried. So, this is the 10 important Indian food fishes. I have explained about these fishes. In conclusion, India holds the second position in the world for freshwater fish farmed production. There is immense scope for its development when improved system and species are adopted. A large extent of Indian aquaculture is still based on traditional farming methods. Converting them to modern farming methods will increase fish production and will also address sustainability of environment. The marine fish farming segment is hitherto updated. The marine fish farming segment is hitherto untapped, and establishing commercial hatchery technologies and suitable farming methods is yet another significant opportunity given the country's vast coastline. So, India has a bright future in the area of the fish production and exploit all the available habitats, because 90% of the water resources are unexploited till now. So I hope the government of India exploit more and more available habitats for fish practices and increase the fish production and achieve the top position in the world. Thank you very much.